Over 50 years ago, Yuri Gagarin became the first human to see the world in a way that no one else had ever seen. He took a huge step for the evolution of mankind by being the first one to travel into space. Following him, today there have been 563 astronauts who have left their mark in the unknown territory of space, but not many have traveled past the lower orbit of the Earth. Are we destined to be chained within our comfort zone, or is it finally the time for humanity to unleash its true potential and reach out for its final frontier? On the 30th of May 2020, SpaceX's Crew Dragon landed two NASA astronauts, Robert and Douglas, at the International Space Station, marking their first human space flight with a private collaboration. What do you think it signals for the future of space exploration? NASA was particularly excited about the SpaceX launch because it signaled its return to sending people into space from the American soil after 9 long years.
We sure appreciate that, sir. It's obviously been our honor to be just a small part of this. We have to give credit to SpaceX, the Commercial Crew Program, and of course NASA. It's great to get the United States back in the crewed launch business, and we're just really glad to be on board this magnificent complex.
NASA became utterly dependent on Russia for space travel, as they had to buy seats on Russian rockets, which cost them about $70.7 million for each one-way ticket. This was because their own space shuttle flight had retired back in 2011. You might ask, why didn't NASA just build their own space shuttle? Well, there were two reasons behind this. One being that the space shuttle program would cost NASA more than $200 billion to operate, and according to NASA, the average cost of launching a space shuttle was about $450 million per mission. Given the limited budget of $19 billion per year, it seemed more feasible to pay $70.7 million to the Russians. And two, after the Columbia crash of 2003, in which astronauts Kalpana Chawla and David M. Brown died, the US government has been reducing the rate at which they increase NASA's budget. And these reductions have raised serious concerns regarding the safety of the spacecrafts. Another important factor to be considered is the cost of the spacesuit. It was originally about $22 million, but now building one from scratch can be as expensive as $250 million. The privatization of the industry is certainly more economical for NASA, as buying a seat on SpaceX's spacecraft cost them $20 million less than what it costed them on Russian spacecrafts. NASA created the Commercial Crew Space Program to spur the development of private launch vehicles that would also be able to serve the commercial customers in addition to the agency.
The Commercial Crew Program is revolutionary in a sense where it's going to provide us the opportunity to have more astronauts in space. It's going to further our ability for knowledge in a microgravity environment.
Companies like SpaceX and Boeing have placed winning bids on the commercial crew contracts and have developed human launch vehicles, although SpaceX is the only one to fly astronauts on their vehicle. The space industry has been promising, but it was not until recently that it began attracting investors. Prior to that, it was not economically viable. Until now, it had been the governments who have been putting people into space for a sustained period of time. Another factor is that the returns from all the investments made in the industry can take many years to materialize. And given the volatility of the industry, not many private players want to take the risk. But again, Elon Musk and Jeff Bezos cannot be stopped. There are a few other players in the industry like Richard Branson, Paul Allen, and even Larry Page, who have been investing massive amounts of money, but the spotlight has always been taken up by the founders of Amazon and Tesla due to their intense rivalry. In fact, recently Musk even tweeted that Amazon should be broken up into multiple companies. They both have a clear vision for the industry and are going to play a major role in its advancement. Fun fact, SpaceX has been buying an enormous amount of land in a village named Boca Chica in Texas so that they can build their private spaceport. According to reports, they are planning to buy the entire village in the next few years and have been relocating the citizens by paying them 3 times more than the actual value of their properties. In fact, Musk has been collaborating with NASA under a $1.6 billion deal to enable colonization and travel to Mars. Reports have also claimed that there are many asteroids floating around in space that consists of more platinum and gold than the entire supply on Earth, and the market value of those asteroids would be in trillions of dollars. Even if we did have the technology to access those resources, there is no way that the benefits derived from them would be substantial enough to cover the costs involved. The fixed cost of R&D to develop a system capable of handling such a mission would easily surpass the budgets of programs like Apollo Moon Landing and the International Space Station. Such a large quantity of gold not being valuable enough can throw some light on how expensive these missions can possibly be. So why are billionaires investing so much in the industry? even though they have a visionary approach of creating a civilization on Mars and the Moon, the research and development happening in the space industry aims at simplifying and adding value to the human life at present on Earth. And that is the trillion-dollar industry that we are talking about. Currently, SpaceX is working on its Starlink project, which aims at sending a small network of satellites into space that would provide a global internet service. Providing a global internet service can mean billions of dollars for them, but at the same time, it could also improve lives of many who have been traditionally disadvantaged with poor or no internet coverage. This is the primary reason why space has suddenly become a lucrative industry. The idea is to unleash humanity to its true potential by exploring the celestial bodies, but at the same time minting money by making life easier for mankind. The satellite segment comprises of 77% of the $360 billion space industry, so it is going to become the backbone of the industry going forward. Morgan Stanley estimates that the global space industry could generate more than $1 trillion in revenue by 2040. Now this is where we talk about the unimaginable. Most of us have seen the movie Interstellar. The concept of the movie is based on space travel and finding a habitable planet other than Earth. Both Blue Origin and SpaceX have clear intentions of commercializing the concept of space travel in the upcoming years, and whenever that becomes a reality, these companies are going to be the major players. In 2001, an American entrepreneur paid $20 million to go to space with the help of the Russians. But now companies like Virgin Galactic and Blue Origins report that the cost per person for traveling into space will come down to just $200,000. Blue Origins is even developing their new Shepard spacecraft, specifically designed for tourism flights into space. The passengers will be able to leave their seats and experience the effect of weightlessness. The current advancements in space flights focus on lowering the cost of space travel by reusing the first stage rocket components. The reusability of rockets could give you a chance to experience the wonders of space for a much lower cost. If each spacecraft can be used multiple times before needing any serious refurbishments, the customer would only have to cover the cost of the fuel and the crew. Look at it from this angle. An aeroplane can conduct tens of thousands of flights during its lifetime. If a rocket can achieve even a fraction of those numbers, space tourism could be opened up to the common folk. Well, wouldn't you want to view the Earth all the way from the outer space? Virgin Galactic is the only publicly traded space company in the world to have been listed on the New York Stock Exchange. Its sister company Virgin Orbit recently got an investment of $1 billion. Jeff Bezos has even explored the opportunity of mining the moon for water. Do you think the idea of space travel seems to be a distant fantasy, or can it actually be achieved? Let us know in the comment section below. The relationship between Russia and USA has been a complicated one. The Russians have been more advanced than the Americans in the industry. The International Space Station is a joint venture between 15 countries, and China is not a part of the agreement because US, along with the other nations, did not trust China and believed that they might use the opportunity for their own military use. Even Russia is planning to launch their own space station in the next few years. Space exploration has always been on the minds of humanity, but due to the influence of state authorities, the industry has always suffered a slow growth. But now, privately funded companies have managed to eliminate many of the inefficiencies, which opens the doors to all of those who wish to travel to space at least once in their lifetime. One might say that this race is a billion-dollar marketing gimmick which would only benefit the rich, but let's not forget how space exploration has changed our lives with the help of advanced technology. Space may be dark, but in this instance, the future is bright. Well, we can all agree upon one thing, and that is at the end of the race into space, the world as we know it will never be the same.